Evening po. Wait lang po sandali ah.
Evening, ma'am.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening po. Naririnig po ako?
Yes,
yes po. Ma'am.
Okay. Good evening po. Pahintay lang po sandali ah yung mga classmate natin kasi tayo po ay 38 pa lang po. So waiting po tayo sa ibang mga kasamahan natin ha. Okay po. 7:15 po mag-start tayo. Ayun. Hello, good evening po. Good evening po sa lahat. Mag-start po tayo.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening. Okay. We are on module 5 of our lesson. Our topic for today or tonight is Elements and Principles of Art. Okay, welcome, St. Maurice and St. Barbara. Our objectives for the day are recall the national artists of the Philippines and their artworks, illustrate the elements and principles of art, evaluate the artworks of national artists of the Philippines and contemporary art forms based on the elements and principles of arts. Appreciate contemporary art forms based on the elements and principles of arts. Okay. ano yung huling pinag-aralan natin noong nakaraan? Kung natatandaan niyo po. Ano po yung huling pinag-aralan natin? Nakapag-submit na po lahat ng assignment ko sa link.
Yes po, ma'am.
Okay, actually hindi ko naman kinlose yung assignment natin. Naka-open pa rin po siya hanggang ngayon. Kaya pwede pa rin po tayong mag-send. Kasi po ay naka-open naman po siya. Meron pa po bang hindi nakakapag-send? Okay. May tanong si Ibanez?
Wala po, ma'am. Doon po yun sa regarding po sa last lesson ng nakaraan.
Hindi ka po nakaabot?
Hindi, ma'am. Sasagot po sana ako eh.
Ay, natapos na namin. Tama? Okay, reminder po ulit bago tayo mag-start. Sagutan natin ang bawat activity. Picturean natin yung score natin sa bawat activity. Then, i-upload po natin sa link. Okay po? Let us start for our activity one. This element of art is used to form shapes. Okay, magsagot po tayo. Nakikita po ba pag ganito lang ang presentation ko?
Maliit po, ma'am.
Maliit. Sige, wait lang po. Wait lang po ah, gagawin ko po ng paraan. Okay na po yung ganito kalaki.
Yes po, ma'am.
Thumbs up po tayo pagtapos na para mailipat ko.
Pang ilang activity po pala yan, ma'am?
Ano po yun?
Ilang activity daw po yan, ma'am? Ilang activity daw po yun, yan, ma'am?
Ay, hindi ko sigurado yung nagawa ko. Pero may pakisagutan lang po. Next slide na po ba? Next slide na po ba? Next na po. Last slide po. Okay na po. Let us check. Okay, mag-start po tayo sa 9 and 10. Sino po ang pwedeng magbasa at sabihin ang kanyang sagot? Sino po ang pwede? Pakibasa po at bigyan ng sagot. Ah, sige, Ira.
Which of the following are the representations of lines in an arc? 1. Horizontal line. 3. Circular line. 2. Curve line. 4. Wave line.
Sa akin po, ma'am, letter D. Para sa'yo, letter D. Sino pa po ang may ibang answer? Queen. Queen Anne?
Good evening po. Yes, letter A po, horizontal line and curved line.
Curved line. Sabi dito, which of the following are the classification of colors? Parang ang tamang sagot po ay letter C. Tertiary color.
Ma'am, ano pong sagot sa number 9?
Complementary color and principal color. Letter C. Nakuha po yung number 10, letter C. Okay, number 9, pakibasa mo nga, Sammy.
Sammy? Which of the following are the presentations of lines in an arc? Ma'am, letter C po.
Letter C. The correct answer is letter D. Letter D, horizontal line, curved line, and circular line. Number 9, 7 and 8 na tayo. Pwede po bang pakibasa? Sino po bang pwede magbasa at magbigay ng sagot? Sige, Maria. Christine. Sino pa po ang pwedeng sumagot? Basahin. Jude Antonio. Nawala ang kamay ni Jude. Janoras.
This principle of art refers to the arrangement of opposite elements used in art, in an art. Letters.
What is your answer?
Letter D po.
Letter D. Number 7 is the correct answer is letter C, contrast. Number 8, which of the following describe the change of value when white is added to a certain color? What do you think is the answer, Rosalie, for number 8?
Letter D po, ma'am. Which of the following describe in the change
Very
of value?
Very good. Letter D. Tint. So number 7 is letter C. Number 8 is letter D. Then number 6. Who can answer and read number 6? Shaira Pascual.
This element of art shows the range of the tones of a color from light to dark. What I need to know, what I know. Sipo.
Number 6, letter C, parang nasagot na yung contrast. Ano ang iyong sagot, Marlon?
Color, ma'am.
Color? Hindi po. The correct answer for number 6?
Letter B, ma'am.
Letter B?
Letter B, value. Number 5, this is the principle of art usually achieved through the repetition of elements used in an art. What is your answer, Jude?
Rhythm po, ma'am.
Very good. That is rhythm. Next, number 4. This is an element of art, implies distance of objects between each other in an art. What is your answer, Ira?
Letter B po, ma'am.
Letter D, space. This, very good. That's the correct answer. This element of art expresses the three-dimensionality of objects in an art. Alin kaya, ano kaya ang sagot dito, John Paul?
A, ma'am, Paul.
No, that's not A.
Ma'am, letter C.
Another answer. I see the correct, I heard the correct answer. Letter C.
Opo, kasi tatlo po yung line.
Next, let us proceed to number 2. This principle of art refers to the dominance given to a certain element in an art. What is your answer, John Paul? Jude, what is your answer?
Proportion po.
The correct answer for number 2 is letter C. Letter B, color. Number 2 is letter B, color. Last number. This element of art is used to form space. What is your answer, Queen Anne?
Letter B po, line.
Letter B, line. Okay, that's the correct answer. So, for number 1, let me repeat.
Mom.
Number 1 is letter B, line. Now, number 2 is letter C, emphasis. Number 3 is letter B, shape. Number 4 is letter D, space. Number 5 is letter B, rhythm. Number 6 is letter B, text B, value. Number 7 is letter C, contrast. Number 8 is letter D, tin. Number 9 is letter D, Roman numeral 1, 2, and 3. And number 10 is letter C, Roman numeral 2, 3, 4. Okay na po, let us proceed. Pakitake po ng pictures ang inyong score. Mamaya po mag-upload ako ng link kung saan nyo pwedeng i-upload. Okay po.
Mamaya po yung letter number 3 kasi po putol-putol yung salitang po sa akin dito may signal.
Mamaya na lang po ulit. Contemporary art forms from the regions. Different kinds of local artworks have sprung not only in the urban centers of the country and in schools of arts or different educational institutions, but also a lot of more of never before seen or heard artworks from the countryside have made known, have become renowned. These artworks are made with the artistic expressions of ideas of various Philippine arts and effectively delivered the message or idea of the artwork within the use of elements. Kagaya na napag-aralan natin nakaraan, marami na talagang mga artwork na nadidiscover sa iba't ibang lugar. Hindi lamang dito sa Maynila, lalo na sa mga probinsya, yung mga kasuluk-sulukan ng mga probinsya, mayroon silang nadidiscover na artwork. So, power activity 2. Ready na po ba ang mga papel natin? Okay po. Pakisagutan po natin. Letter lang po ang isusulat natin, ha? From the box below, determine the Philippine national artist that is described in each statement. Write the letter of your answer on your answer sheet. Done na po. Okay po, ito na po yung number 3 and number 4. Number 2 and number 3, sorry. Thumbs up po tayo pagtapos na para mailipat ko po. Okay, number 4 and number 5. Okay na po, check na natin. Okay, let us proceed. Who can read and answer number 1? Sige nga po, Ira.
He sculpted the oblation in 1935, which is located at the University of the Philippines campus in Diliman, Quezon City. Letter C po, Ma'am, Guillermo Tolentino.
Yes, very good. That is letter C. Guillermo Tolentino. Number 2. Who can read and answer? Kindly answer Sammy and
he founded the UP Center for Ethnomusicology. Letter A po, ma'am. Jose Maceda po.
Okay, very good. That's correct. Jose Maceda. Next, number 3. Who will? Jude Antonio.
He collaborated with Carlos V. Francisco in the film Genghis Khan in 1950 that tells the epic adventure of a Mongolian conqueror. Letter D po, ma'am. Manuel Conde.
Letter D. Very good. Manuel Conde. Next natin. Number 4. Vincent Paul.
F, ma'am. Oh, basahin ko pa po ba, ma'am?
Yes po.
He wrote the libretto recounting the origins of the Manobo people. F, ma'am.
Very Benvenido. Good. Letter F. Benvenido Lombera. Last number, Marlon Cabiles.
She is the founder of Bullet Philippines. Letter G, ma'am. Alice Reyes.
Okay, very good. Alice Reyes. Okay, pakipicturan po mamaya. Kahit mamaya na po. Mag-start tayo ulit. Okay, let us start. Our previous lesson described the various contemporary art forms from the Philippines based on the elements and principle of arts. And you have learned of national artists of the Philippines and their contribution. Now, did you ever wonder how the elements and principle of arts used in making artists an artwork? Meron po akong artwork na ipapakita. Start learning the elements and principles of this. Examine the following image of artwork and process your thoughts with the help of your guide questions. Titingnan nyo po itong artwork na to, then you are going to answer the guide questions. Ito po yung artwork. Wait lang po. Wait lang po ah. Okay, may papakita po akong picture. Then, meron pong guide questions para po, tingnan nyo po maigi yung picture. Okay, wait lang po. I-present ko ulit yung aking slides. Nakikita po?
Yes po, ma'am.
Ayan. Ang title ng artwork ay Thinking Man by Kiyoko Redro by Mervin Mude. Okay. Meron akong guide questions. Titigan nyo maigi yung picture, ha? Okay, these are my guide questions. Okay. How does the shape and forms define the subject of artwork? Ano daw po yung paano nyo? Nakikita nyo po sa may itaas? Ito po. Yung shape niya daw at yung forma niya. How does the shape and forms define the subject? Ano sa palagay nyo ang ipinapakita ng forma ng artwork na yan? Ano ang pinapakita? Merong na kayo kong mama, medyo ano. Ano sa palagay nyo? Ano yung emotion ng artwork na yan? Ira? Ano sa palagay nyo?
Ano po, ma'am? Yung shape niya, ma'am, curved line. Tapos line.
Opo. Malungkot, sabi niya, no? Overthinking. Masyado raw nag-iisip. Stress, sabi nung isa. Okay, problemado po, ma'am. Ayan. Yun ang pinapakita ng artwork na yan. No? Nakayuko siya. Marami siyang iniisip. Parang yung problema, lahat nasa ulo niya na, no? Masyado siyang nag-overthink sa mga problema niya. Yan yung pinapakita ng artwork na yan. Eh, alam niyo po ba na ang art ay may elements? So, meron siyang 7 elements. Okay, ito po. Mag-start tayo dito sa line. Elements of arts. An element of art that is used to define shape, contours, outlines, also to suggest mass and volume. It may be a continuous mark made of the surface with pointed tool or applied by the edges of shapes and forms. Line may come in two characteristics. Ito po yung example ng line. Nakikita niyo po ang aking screen? Ayan po. Nakikita po ba?
Yes po.
Ayan. Ito po yung ano, may dalawang characteristic po ang lines. Merong curve, may dotted, or broken lines. So, yun yung form. Sa dalawang characteristic ng line, form at saka direction. Pag sinabing form, nandyan yung curve, dotted, and broken lines. Pag sinabi namang direction, vertical, horizontal, or diagonal. There are different characteristics of lines may convey different meanings. Meron daw pong iba't ibang ibig sabihin ang bawat linya na yan. So kapag horizontal lines, an expression of serenity and perfect stability. Pag vertical naman po, naririnig po ako. Pag sinabi pong vertical creates an impression of strength, perfect stability. Pag diagonal naman po, Ito po yan ha, yung magkasunod-sunod na yan ha. Vertical line. Ito yung horizontal. Ayan yung vertical. Ito naman po yung diagonal. Creates an impression of action. Curve naman po, line creates gradual change of direction. Ayan po, pabago-bago daw. Pag circular naman po, creates an impression of abrupt change of direction. Ulitin ko po, ito pong nasa unahan, yan po ay horizontal, ito po ay vertical, ito po ay diagonal. This one is a curve line. And this is the circular line. Okay. Moreover, lines can be classified into different types. May iba't ibang classification din ang linya. Merong outlines made of the edges of the object or silhouette. Ito po ay nasa dulo. Contour lines describe the shape of an object and interior detail. Sketch naman po, expressive lines catch the movement and gesture of an active figure. Letter D is a sketch lines capture the appearance of an object or impression of a place. Calligraphy lines, ito po yon. Are the elegant handwriting of lettering done by hand. Implied lines are lines not actually drawn but created by a group of objects. Yan po ang tungkol sa lines. Ilan po ang merong elements ng arts? Meron tayong 7, hindi po ba? So yan po yung sa lines. Next po natin ay sa shape. Ito po yung sa shape. Shape is an area that closed by line or lines. Shapes are two-dimensional figures with height and width. There are different kinds of shapes and these are geographic shapes, organic shapes, positive shapes, negative shapes, static shapes, and dynamic shapes. Geometric shapes are circles, squares, rectangles, triangles, and other geometric shapes. Organic shapes are shapes found in the nature and are free-flowing, informal, and irregular, also known as abstract. Positive shapes are the solid forms in a design. Negative shapes are space around the positive shape. Static shapes are shapes that appear stable and resting. Dynamic shapes are shapes that appear and active. Next is the color. Colors are the way we see light reflected from the surface of the refracted through a prism. Colors we see in the nature are reflection of light on the surfaces around us. We can classify colors into a primary, secondary, tertiary, and analogous. What are the primary colors? Primary colors are red, blue, and yellow. Secondary colors are resulting colors with the two of the primary colors are mixed. They are the purple, green, and orange. Tertiary colors are resulting into colors when two, the primary and the secondary colors are mixed. The tertiary colors are amber, vermilion, magenta, violet, teal, and chartreuse. Analogous colors are colors that lie next to each other based on the color wheel. Example of analogous color. are yellow, orange, and red. Complementary colors. Colors that are opposite to each other based on the color wheel. Example of the complementary colors are red and green, blue and orange, purple and yellow. Monochromatic colors are several values of one color. Warm colors are colors that give a feeling of warmth. The warm colors are yellow, amber, orange, vermilion, red, and magenta. Cool colors are colors that give the feeling of coolness. The cool colors are purple, violet, blue, teal, green, chartreuse. Next natin ay ang space. Space refers to distance of areas around, between, or within the components of a piece and refers to the arrangement of objects on the picture. Two-dimensional. In visual arts, space may either be positive space or negative space. Pag sinabi natin positive, refers to the part of which enclosed in a shape. Meanwhile, negative refers to the opposite part which shape is enclosing. Moreover, perspective is a technical means by which we perceive distance in painting, by which we are to see the position of the objects. Ayan po yung example na positive at negative. So, pag sinabing positive, refers to the part enclosed in a shape. Opposite naman po yung negative. In a point of perspective, we perceive the position of the object meets at one point on the horizontal line. Yan po yung example ng positive at negative. Next is the texture. Nakikita po yung aking slides? Ah, okay po. Kala ko po hindi nyo nakikita. Wait lang po ah. Texture, there are two types of texture. Texture is the element that appeals to our sense of feel. Hinahawakan natin. Things are rough or smooth, bumpy or slippery. It is character of the surface of an artwork. A real texture is the actual texture of an object. Artists may create a real texture in an art to give it visual interest or evoke a feeling. Implied texture naman made the piece of art look like a certain texture. Like a drawing of a tree. Excuse me. Tree trunk. May look rough, but in fact, it's just a smooth piece of paper. Halimbawa po yung bulaklak. Ito yung picture na nasa taas. Yan yung parang real picture niya. Yung nandito naman po, kung yung original na nasa taas, makulay siya. Pag implied naman po, ayan po, parang bare lang yung kanyang picture. Next natin is value. Value is pertains to the lightness or darkness of a color in a given artwork. Value can be changed by adding white or black to a color, and this described as a tint and shade. Tint pertains to the lightness of color. Shade pertains to the darkness. Pag sinabing tint, light ang color niya. Pag sinabing shade, dark naman yung color niya. Yun yung pinagkaiba ng tint at shade. Form. It is a three-dimensional of an object. It has a dimensions of height, width, and length. Pag sinabing three-dimensional, pag tinignan mo siya, parang 3D art, ganyan. Nakapunta na po ba kayo sa art museum? Yan yung may sample ng 3D art. Wow, nakapunta na yung iba. Meron po ba kayong klase ng 8 o'clock? Ang Maurice po ba, wala ng klase? Wala. Ah, how about ang Barbara? May klase pa po ang Barbara? Yes, Virgilio?
Sorry po ma'am, napindot ko. Susulat ako eh.
Okay, may klase po ba ang Barbara ng 8 o'clock? This is Maurice and Barbara, di ba? Tuloy ko na po ah, tapusin ko na po. Okay, let us proceed. Tapos na po tayo sa elements. Pakibigay nga po ulit ang 7 elements na ating napag-aralan. Magbigay nga po nung una. Kahit hindi po magkakasunod, okay lang po. Queen Anne?
Seven elements.
Okay, go Queen Anne.
7 elements of arts. 1, line, shape, color, space, texture, value, and form.
Wow, thank you very much. Well said. Meron tayong 7 elements of art. Naririnig po ba ako? Ayan, wait lang po sandali ha. Ayusin ko lang po. Yes po. Naririnig na po ako. Yan po, naririnig ako. Yan yes, po, okay ma'am. Na po ba? Thumbs up po tayo pag okay na. Para alam ko po. Ayan, okay po. Let us proceed to principles. Meron naman tayo ditong meron tayong 8 principles. Kung kanina meron tayong 7 na elements, ngayon po meron tayong 8 principles. So ang una po natin, I read them. This refers to repetition of certain elements to produce a pattern. Yung nandito po sa gilid, ito po, yan po yung sample ng rhythm. Next natin ay yung movement. Movement is the illusion of motion in a painting, sculpture, or design. Example of this, ito po, nasa gilid. Balance repair to the visuals. Weight in a picture. It refers to the given distribution of position of elements in an artwork. The people balance can be symmetrical or asymmetrical. Pag sinabing symmetrical, pag pinold mo yan, pag pinold mo tong cross na to, even pag binaliktad mo yan, same pa rin yung magiging picture niya. Pag sinabing asymmetrical, magkaiba na siya. Represent an artwork wherein the balance through the contrast or differences and elements of art. Dun sa symmetrical, yung both sides niya, the same elements. Dito naman sa asymmetrical, hindi siya magkaparehas. Okay, proportion. Proportion refers to the relationship of the size objects in a body upward. Ito po, hindi proportion yung kanya. Kasi nagsimula siya sa maliit na bilog hanggang sa papalaki. Contrast is the principle shows different between elements of artwork. Art in an artwork. Kagaya niyan, it shows how stronger each element of art in relation to one another. Itong dalawang star na moon na merong marami siyang rays o araw na maraming rays, parehas lang po siya. Pero ang pinagkaiba niya lang, lightness at saka darkness. Yung isa sa puti, yung isa naman po sa itim. Variety is the principle of art, refers to diversity of different elements of use in an artwork to make it interesting. Ito po yung sample niya sa gilid. Ano po ba yung nakikita natin dyan sa picture na yan? So, para siyang may flower, ano? Sa variety, sa emphasis naman po, is refers to the greater impact of highlight given to a certain element of an artwork. Ito po yung sample niya sa gilid. The last one is harmony. This principle art refers to unity of an artwork. It is about the arrangement of the related elements that makes an artwork to be viewed as a whole. Itong sample niya na to, ang nakalagay, inhale, exhale. So, meron tayong walo. Walo na principle. Ano-ano nga ulit yon? Magbigay ka nga ng isa lang muna. Jocil?
Isa lang po, ma'am, o lahat?
Isa lang po muna, sige.
Okay po, ma'am, redeem.
Okay, next. Shaira?
Movement.
Movement. Ira?
Balance po, ma'am.
Balance. Sami?
Contrast po, ma'am.
Contrast. Dennis?
Harmony po.
Harmony. Parang harmony. How about John Paul?
Proportion, ma'am.
Proportion. Meron pa. Sino pa pong nagtataas ang kamay? Jude?
Variety po.
Variety. Meron pa? Jocelyn?
Emphasis po, ma'am.
Emphasis. Meron pa po ba, Dennis? Meron pa
nasabi
po?
Nasabi na lahat, ma'am.
Nasabi na lahat. Okay. Wait lang po, ha? Okay, narinig po ako? Okay, these are the example of artwork based on elements and principles of art. Ano po ang nakikita nyo dito sa art na to? It was the made of the national artist in the Philippines by Hernando Ocampo, entitled Genesis. Some of the elements that could be seen in the canvas. In my own opinion, it will be the lines, curve. Ano pa yung nakikita nyo dyan? Okay. Sige po. Let us end this discussion. Isisend ko po ang presentation ko na to. Tapos magre-review po tayo para po sa ating exam. Magbibigay po ako ng pointers to review sa GC natin. Para po kahit papaano, makapag-review kayo na magiging test natin. By Wednesday or Thursday, isisend ko po yung online na ating exam. Pakisagutan po ito within 24 hours. Magbibigay ako ng pointers to review para po mag-review kayo bago nyo masagutan. Okay po? Naririnig po ako? Sige po, yes. Pwede po ba tayo pwede po ba tayo magbukas ng camera natin? Para po mag-picture po tayo.
Ma'am, naka-mute po kayo.
Okay, isa pa po. Sorry. Okay, wala na po muna mag-chat para makuha tayong lahat. Ayan, 1, 2, 3. Kung wala na po kayong tanong, pwede na po tayong mag-out. By Wednesday or Thursday po, isi-send ko yung ating exam. Pero bukas sa Monday po, magbibigay ako ng pointers to review para meron kayong gagamitin sa inyong pagsagot. Okay po? Kung wala na po kayong questions, maraming salamat po sa pagpasok. Hanggang sa susunod po. Thank you po.
Okay po, ma'am. Salamat.
Thank you po.
Bye. Good night po.